No, you
can. It's Tasty Thursday!
Oh, God, it's so good.
So good.
All the new hot food trends, Daddy.
So good and tasty.
That's right, guys. So, here on Thursdays, we have three things, Nico and Josh. We got our taste. Oh, almost took the guys off. We got the tasties. We got the what happened does.
Yeah, what's the third one? That's it.
Therapy.
Oh, Thursday therapy. We haven't done that in a while.
Yeah, we have.
We never have time for it, guys. You can see we have good breaks here. Yeah. All right? Even the smallest thing becomes the biggest thing.
Hey, yo.
Like, for example, last week we got one of our first calls in a while because we're talking about pizza. Someone tried to do the same thing here, talking about pasta. So call us up at 516-572-7440 because we want your opinions on pasta. Because the food critic, or let me figure out what this news place is called. The food editor, the kitchen editor,
yeah,
has come out with their 11 best pasta, noodle, and rice dishes. And number one is baked ziti.
I love a good baked ziti.
Is your favorite pasta baked ziti?
I definitely say it's in the top three.
What's top one for you?
Probably baked ziti.
He definitely like wiggles his fingers and goes like, don't mind if I do every time he sees baked ziti.
What's number two for you?
Probably lasagna. Like lasagna. My good pal Garfield. Well, me and Garfield, we hate Mondays and we love lasagna.
I'm not gonna ask about three. Sandy, what's your favorite pasta? Do you like pasta?
Yes, penne alla vodka, easy.
Penne alla vodka. You can't go on a nice penne alla vodka.
I always get extra sauce. That's the only way to go.
Don't think about that one. It's like you're drowning it.
That's exactly what I want. I want it to be drowned. I want to be scooping up the sauce like a soup.
Interesting.
You guys don't understand my dedication.
Well, alrighty. Nico, you a big pasta guy? You like Italian food?
Huge. Well, I am Italian.
You are, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Are you?
I am.
I did not get that from you.
No.
You're half Italian,
I'm
right?
half Italian. Yeah.
Half what's Latino. The other half? Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Gross.
Yeah, no, I hate Spanish people.
Guys, no one knows where you guys are. You're not being visualized, okay?
Hi,
we're on air.
Me, Nico, and Antonio are all Hispanic
geez,
people.
Louise. Yeah. Last week, Nico, we dropped a beaner bomb on Frank.
Yeah.
And so Justin was like, they could say it. And Frank goes, yeah, I guess they could. I don't think he understood what it was, but he agreed with Justin.
How do you feel about non-beaner saying beaner?
I don't think I care at all. Like, it's just as long as it's Goya. But regardless, though.
So, all right. So
what's
my
your
dish
favorite pasta,
is,
Nico?
Spicy rigatoni alla vodka.
Wow. Ooh. Very niche, very specific. This guy knows his pastas. Whoa. Come on now.
Do you know the pastas all have different shapes to them?
What?
Dictating like what sauces go on them? I just found this out recently. I had no idea. Like you're supposed to use a specific sauce for, you know, you go to the supermarket and all the pastas have different shapes to them. You know, some of them will be like a corkscrew looking device.
Yeah, because some of them are better at holding sauces than others.
I just found that out.
Really?
Idiot.
Honestly, you just talk about that now, Justin. I don't know anything about that. Does that mean penne is supposed to like sandwich a little sauce in the tube?
I'm guessing they use the specific.
Try to get as much in the tube.
And also like the little crevices like on the outside like also make sauce stick to them better.
Interesting. Mm-hmm. All right. How about you, Josh? Big pasta guy?
Lasagna I can rock with.
Lasagna?
Does that count? Yeah.
Lasagna counts. It's very common pasta.
Yeah, I'll go
it's
with
pasta cake.
I'm surprised none of you guys have said Alfredo.
Ugh.
No.
None of you guys like Alfredo.
Alfredo would like kill me for a week.
Would kill you? You a big lactose guy?
Yeah.
I'm traumatized by Alfredo because that's all my ex would cook every single night.
Oh, really?
I would come home and be like, all right, what's for dinner? Oh, I'm making fettuccine Alfredo, I think it is. I'm like, oh, again? Cool. Awesome.
Jeez.
You come home from a hard day's work, you expect to be greeted with a nice steak on the table.
Thank you, Justin.
What is she doing all day? Sitting around watching her soap operas and sewing?
We're losing recipes.
No! He deserves a fresh cooked meal!
Lost all the recipes.
A damn shame.
I'm not learning from mom how to cook.
Might as well put a gun in my mouth.
Facts.
We got somebody.
Is this the pizza guy calling the guy?
Maybe you want to give their answer. Caller, you're on air, and let us know, what's your favorite pasta?
There's some marble. Well,
I'm sad, but you don't know what you're talking about. You got to take it from a real Italian, born in Italy. I go there every year. My parents are born there. My sister's born there, and I eat Italian every day.
That's right. Take it easy.
you gotta start with the best pasta around, and that would be linguine with clams.
Oh! Tell me about it. Tell me about it.
All right, you have a choice. You can get in a red sauce or a white sauce. The white sauce is basically a garlic sauce. The red sauce is delicious sweet clams in a red sauce. Both of those are number one. Okay, so the second best pasta dish is pasta carbonara. None of you mentioned that.
Oh, I love carbonara. I totally forgot about
that. You guys hit me with ziti and lasagna. You joking me? That's like American Italian. You got to go with the real deal. Pasta carbonara rocks. And then
fly me out to Italy.
I'll never forget.
Fly me out, man.
I'll never forget this one time I went to an Italian restaurant. I ordered carbonara and I saw like full pieces of like egg whites and egg yolks in it. And I was like, oh my gosh, are you serious? It tasted like pure, like bad.
Wow.
You know
damn.
What they did wrong? The idea is that you throw the egg in at the very end before, and you don't let it cook. That's the mistake they made. You said it was pieces of egg, right? Which means they didn't make it right.
They didn't do their job.
There's a technique. You gotta throw it in and whip it up real quick before it allows the heat to cook the egg. So that's a mistake that restaurant made. They don't know what they're doing.
Talking
about pasta or childbirth?
Right. Go to a good Italian restaurant and you'll see that.
Yeah, go to like the Olive Garden. Go to a nice Italian restaurant.
You're right. I never thought of that.
That's a joke, man. That's a joke. Come on. All right, I'm gonna give you the last. That's number three. Gnocchi.
Oh, I love me some good gnocchi. You're not wrong there.
Gnocchi and pesto sauce. And a green pesto. That's
I love a pesto. I love pesto.
I've never tried gnocchi with pesto.
That's good. The way to go, boy. All three of those pasta dishes rock, and you can't compare. Ziti is, like I said, American Italian. Everybody brings that to parties. I'm making ziti. I'm making lasagna. Forget about those. Hey, I'm talking here. I know what I'm talking
about. I'm talking here. You know, you should listen.
How long I got to wait? All right. You guys have a good day, all right?
Thank you, man.
Have a good one. Thank you for calling.
Appreciate it.
Sure. Bye-bye.
And listen to Profuma d'Italia tonight at 5 p.m.
That's right.
With your host, Rita Monte.
Mm-hmm.
I take you on a gondola ride across the river of all Italian music.
Wow, that man has to be the most Italian man I ever heard in my life. Might have been Tony Soprano right there. That might have been Tony Soprano himself.
I feel like we're Italian by proxy now.
Yeah, just by speaking to that man. I was going to ask him how he felt about pasta primavera, because that was a big one that was always ordered at my diner, and I never understood the point of it. Does not look very great.
Really?
No, it doesn't look all that great.
I enjoy it.
What about Kraft macaroni and cheese?
Oh,
thoughts, comments, concerns?
Now, is mac and cheese a pasta is what I want to know.
Yeah.
Yeah, you think so?
It's cheese delicious. Sauce. It's a cheese sauce.
I wouldn't call it like a pasta on the same level that like, you know, the rest of the pasta that we named were. It's more so just like American.
It's a poor man's
pasta.
And
what's wrong with America? The greatest country in the land. 50 stars, 13 bars. I love the good old USA. And if you don't like it, you can get
every time I hear this, I literally want to tear all the hair out of my scalp one by one. I want to tear off my skin and my fingernails every time I hear somebody say this.
Speaking of fingernails and tearing off of things,
no segue for this.
Up next on Tasty Thursday is Olive Garden, all right? Mm. Where they're being sued over a man allegedly finding a rat's foot in his soup.
Rat's foot.
That's just a little garnish, man. Come on, you go to the Olive Garden, you expect a little rat's foot, maybe a baby's fingernail.
That's luck.
And it's what
that's
it is.
Maybe a baby.
Perhaps a full-on baby.
People don't appreciate their proteins anymore.
I'm just sad because that guy's gonna get the last good meal of the day because Ratatouille just died in the soup.
Oh,
he was trying to make that soup the best he could, and he ended up in the soup.
Sad little rat.
Regardless, though, Olive Garden is fighting back. They're not putting no hush money in because they believe that foot was a plant.
That's a good idea.
They thought that he brought his own foot, put it in the soup.
You know, he killed his own rat.
He would just like kill a rat.
His rat in the food.
They're saying that rat was a plant. They're saying that. I mean, think about it, right? It's not a Burger King. I can believe this happening in a Burger King. All right.
No, this happened at a Wendy's one time.
It happened at a Wendy's.
Did they find a finger in a chili?
They found a finger. Yep, in chili.
Exactly. It could happen in Popeyes. You know what I mean? But at Olive Garden, I feel like it's a little bit.
When you're there,
you know,
your family.
When you're there, you're in Italy, basically. You know what I mean? So, I don't know. I feel as if, though, like, it's possible. Because think about it. In order for this foot to end up in the soup, because if you look at the picture, it's a perfect severed foot. So that means someone in the kitchen, out of, you know,
malice
intent, had to chop the foot. put it in the soup, it's a perfect cut. It doesn't make sense. Maybe if it was like, you know, a whole like leg or like the whole body was in it, somehow it'd make kind of sense. Or maybe if it was a deep fried.
Yeah.
But it was a perfect like
beautiful foot.
In the soup. Yep, you can see the claw. He's saying that he got scratched in his mouth.
He ate it?
He apparently put it in his mouth and then he spit it out. And that's when he noticed it was a whole rat foot.
Now, there has to be video footage of the inside this restaurant.
There's a picture of the rat foot, but there's no video.
There has to be. There's videos everywhere now. I went to a restaurant a few months ago, a really nice restaurant around here, Italian place, mm-hmm. and we saw a cockroach.
Really?
Mm-hmm. You know, we were seated Yummy. Near the
hey,
kitchen area.
Don't be rude. That's one of the chefs, obviously.
The little cockroach?
It could yes. be.
Well, anyone can be a cook, guys. What are we talking about
right
now?
Ratatouille taught us.
Did Ratatouille teach you nothing?
Mm-hmm. I'll be honest with you. As somebody who's worked near food, no matter how sanitary you think every place is,
it's
there's
not.
Going to be bugs and most likely mice. If you just have that much food, even if it's a five-star restaurant, they're going to find a way. Rats and mice don't discriminate between the poor and the rich. Now, the rich will be able to get rid of it and maybe hide it a little bit better. But as somebody who worked in a supermarket, somebody who worked in a movie theater, there was always critters roaming around. So what we did, and this is why I think this planted foot is actually a smart idea, because we complained about the cockroach and they gave us a free meal. And we got like $150 worth of stuff.
Oh, wow.
And we got more once we found out we were being, treated to the free meal. We're like, all right, let's get three desserts. And we just kept on ordering drinks and we took advantage of that. So, yeah, maybe if you bring a little bug with you, you throw it on the floor. Little tip out there for anybody who's going through some hard times.
I know where we're going after the show.
Olive Garden?
Jail.
Yeah.
Definitely. A couple of things have taught us. Yeah, a couple of things. Looks like we're going to jail. A couple of things you said. You guys ever had an experience like that at a restaurant? Besides Justin?
I'm trying to figure out what I have to do to get a lifetime food deal from, I don't know, Chick-fil-A. What, do I got to drop a cow's tongue in the mac and cheese?
Cow's tongue.
So you think that works?
That's a delicacy.
Oh, my God. A cow's tongue. That's crazy.
Honestly, I thought the highlight was him calling us and telling a bunch of pastas I never heard the name of.
No, you just got to like nod your head and be like, yeah.
You actually ever tried that? You tried that before, saying the pasta carbonara?
Carbonara?
Carbonara. Is that good?
Yeah, I love it. Me and my partner make it every year for Valentine's.
Oh, do you do the little Lady and the Tramp? You know, and you kiss, you meet in the middle,
no,
sucking on the
gay.
Spaghetti string?
We aren't gay. I love my girlfriend, though.
Right.
You guys never tried that with your dog?
Wait.
What?
With my dog?
Yeah, you give your dog like a string of cheese and then
what?
You guys like sort of like meat in the middle.
Do you make out with your dog, Justin?
Not anymore, because she got like a bunch of diseases.
Who gave the dog the disease?
No, we had our prime time years, our peanut butter years, I call them.
I don't think I like that. I don't like the sound of that.
But now she's got like skin infection. It's disgusting.
Man, love. I guess your love was an unconditional.
No.
The glory years are the glory years, Justin. You gotta cherish them for what they were.
I'll never forget the glory hole years.
Did we ever have any accidents?
No, not with this dog. The other dog. Yeah.
Okay.
The old dog. Yeah, there was an incident. I got stitches.
You like cougar dogs or
cougar?
You like them young.
Well, dogs age differently.
This is going a bit far.
So, like in dog years, it was legal.
You know what, Justin? Out with the old and with the new, my guy.
Exactly.
You're living life right.
That's why I eat in the bathroom. Out with the old and with the new.
Oh, jeez. That's why I eat in the bathroom.
Amazed.
I love that.
Come on, you guys have never gone to the bathroom with a cookie?
Nico's broken, it's just...
I'm not gonna lie, I have gone to the bathroom while already consuming a cookie. I'm like, I gotta finish this cookie. I'm gonna put it down. I'm gonna bite away. I eat the...
You guys eat in the shower?
No, I can't eat in the shower.
I used to eat cereal in the shower because it was just... It gets my day faster.
Spaghetti in the shower.
I would drink in the shower.
I've done that too.
Who hasn't done that?
What exactly would you drink in the shower?
Like a Corona or like some wine or something. You're just chilling, getting ready for the evening.
A nice Cabernet. The water can kind of season it.
Horse juice.
Water down.
Are you also like showering fully dressed? Like what?
No, you just put your little wine or your bottle where the soap is, and then the I have a problem. I'm a raging alcoholic.
Alternate back and forth, like, you know, wash the arm.
Yeah.
Take a sip.
Then you mess up. You shove a bottle somewhere it's not supposed to be.
What? Let go!
Oh, I kind of like it.
Oh.
Yeah, one guy with a bottle.
We're going to get yelled at.
This has been a nice Thursday welcome to
Daddy.
What do you think of our debut of me and Nico, Antonio?
I'm excited, but you guys got to prove it to me, man. Because every time I've been on a show with you guys always leave. Or you guys don't show up last second. Screwing me over.
That's not true.
It is true on Nico's part, at least, sure. This guy's a guarantee at that.
I'm gonna screw you over. I'll screw you. I mean.
Regardless, but yeah, I'm excited, guys. All right?
Are you?
I'm excited.
I'm excited too.
Just don't let me down.
So excited.
Don't let me down, all right? Yay. We got a lot of things coming up. I'm trying to find new T things. All right, we got to find new things that start with a T to do this.
Oh, for Thursday.
Transitioning.
So, I'm going
to. I'm bringing the estrogen. Thursday.
I have 6 words I could say that would get me canceled right now.
So say it.
No.
Say one.
Maybe next week.
Transformers.
Transformer Thursdays.
Transitioning Thursdays.
Tricky Thursdays. Tickle Thursdays.
Please, I don't want to get tickled.
Someone's getting tickled.
I got a feather.
Oh, no. I don't like this.
Let's see what else we have. Touchy Thursday.
Touchy Thursday.
That sounds promising. That sounds promising.
Let's just end the show, guys. All right. It's been a heck of a day, guys. Enjoy your weekend.
Stay safe.
Stay safe. Everyone out there, don't vape. Don't drink.
Yeah.
Especially not in the shower. Okay? Don't